The second episode of my new project Unspook AD features both the addition of a new castle above the village, but also its total destruction. In this classic time-lapse video, I'd like to show you how all these rather unique builds came into being, so stay tuned. Hey guys, my name is Titan and I welcome you to the second video of the second episode of my still new project Unspook AD, in which we focus on the whole development of a fictional central European town through more than 1000 years. So far with this second episode now, the first 100 years have passed and as you hopefully know from the story video last week, quite a few things happened in these next 100 years now. The first major addition to the town is the construction of a castle, of the first castle of Unspook, a small wooden construction, which I'm doing right here, right now. Before I started creating this whole castle, I did my research into how actually did early medieval castles look like, because as you might imagine, nowadays there aren't that many of them left, and the ones that are left, yeah, they survived for more than 1000 years, and so they changed so massively that it's not possible to say anymore how it looked back in the days. But there is some solid there was some solid research in that field, and so it's sort of there is an idea how these castles looked like, and that is what I'm doing here. So the center of this wooden castle of Unspook is a standard Mott and Bailey castle, as it can still be seen in most dominantly in on the British islands, or more specifically in southern England, I might say. For example, Windsor Castle is a very classic Mott and Bailey castle. Mott and Bailey basically just means you have a bailey, and attached to that bailey is a mott, a small hill with a keep on top, usually a wooden keep, of course. And so this is also where we start here with this first wooden castle of Unspook. That, as I imagine it for the story, the very first Count of Unspook constructed to take care of the village. So far, I started with the 925 build, or with the 925 AD version of that castle. Reason is that I first made this version, and only later will make the simpler version that is actually really the first wooden castle. We'll get there in just a few minutes. But yeah, it was really great using all these custom networks, custom props, custom assets to this degree here. And I think this is a sort of unique build that really hasn't been done on that scale so far within the game. And if I may say so without being too rude or something, I think I achieved a pretty authentic and realistic look with that first wooden castle. In the end, at least, so far it's still under construction. So what you're seeing so far is like the inner castle, which has a proper wooden wall. It's not really a palisade anymore based on it, or with its stone foundation. It's really a wall, and an outer castle yard that just has a wooden palisade around it. Between the two is a moat, which is what I'm doing here, and based on the fact that this moat has to be really small, I think you are able to see I definitely had some problems achieving the right look here. Because the terrain resolution, meaning the sort of the grid pattern in which the terrain can be lowered or raised, is I think based on a 8-meter grid, and so you can't really make really small moats or ditches or creeks or whatever. So my idea was that I used the slope networks from DX, and I think that at least gave it a more realistic feeling to it, more realistic for a narrow castle moat at least. So far I haven't been really satisfied with the with the shape of the outer castle yard, and yeah, I'm changing that here because it seemed too round to me, it wasn't a shape that seemed in any way realistic for a castle back then or in any age basically, and so I changed it. Now inside the castle are just some thatched roof small earth fast houses. Reason for that is of course that this is some, maybe not poor, but definitely not a very, very important or powerful lower noble that rules here. So he doesn't have the money, or that person, whoever it is, doesn't or didn't have the money to fund the construction of a big stone palace. Back then, maybe only the kings and emperors had that money, but even that, not in every case. And so it's really just a small wooden castle and a few earth-fast houses with thatched roofing inside it that the nobles live in, the lord lives in, and then there is the wooden keep or the wooden tower that is the keep that is for purely defensive reasons. You don't live in the tower. You live in the buildings next to it, and the tower is for defensive reasons primarily. But it's also, of course, a great lookout tower. Now, since, of course, you need a lot of wood to build this castle, but also just to heat it, I transformed the greater area around it into this, wasteland might be a bit far stretching, but into this area where you can see that a lot of trees were cut down to provide the woods for the construction of this castle. But also, as I already did it in the last episode, I planted a lot of smaller trees just for the fact to, just to somewhat show that, yes, all of the major trees were cut down, but since then a few years have passed and again small trees are growing again, and you'd be really surprised how quickly that can go. Like for example, if a huge forest burns down, it's just 1 year and there were small trees again. And so it seemed really justified and realistic to me to also plop all these small trees there. Now I'm already at the stage where I'm detailing the castle itself, but to be honest, there is not really too much that I need to talk about here, since it's just the, I might say, standard way of detailing that I will be doing for quite a lot of the next episodes, with a lot of dirt and mud decals and a lot of the small wheat plant by Mr. Mason, but also smaller things like wood piles and some small crop fields in the on the plots of lands there around the houses. And yeah, just some greenery to make it look more, yeah, I don't know, more realistic, more interesting, not as boring. But of course, you see me doing here, I'm also using the greenery to hide the fact that my idea with the slope networks, yeah, it didn't work quite as good as I hoped it would work. So yeah, here using just some probable surfaces and just some greenery on top of it. By the time we're reaching this point, now I managed to create my own dirt road networks specifically for this series. Don't worry, they will be released as well, and so I can change them. And also with the bridge now in front of the gate, it looks really much better. And just the last small addition, these few warrior props I'm placing all around the castle. Yeah, you know, just to make it at least look more lived in. Of course, they're just props, since you can't make animated props, so they're static. But yeah, to be honest, if they're just guards standing there, it's okay if they're static. Moving forward, or moving backwards actually, to 850 AD, and that is now that where I transform the 925, I think, I hope so, version of the castle into the 850 AD version of the castle, which is the actual first castle of Unspook, and it's a much smaller castle. So what is the inner castle yard, or the inner bailey of the castle we just built, will be the only bailey of the first castle. And you see me basically just removing huge parts of the castle and drawing a new palisade fence in 3-2-1. There we go. A new palisade fence around the inner, or around the castle. So what we're seeing now is the actual first castle of Unspork, a really small wooden castle. But if you look at the year 850 AD, in basically no man's land here, you really didn't have the possibilities to build anything bigger. And again, just to make it more interesting and more lived in, I'm plopping some warrior props around the castle. And now, moving forward to the Magyar attack, or to be more precise, the aftermath of the Magyar attack. If you watched the first video, the story video of this episode, you see that the Magyars came to the village and destroyed everything. And now I'd like to show you how I did that, because I really had fun in the process of making it, but it also is something that I would say is really unique, and so I definitely wanted to include it in this video as well. You see that I'm using a lot of PO here, and that is just, it gives me so much freedom into, yeah, simulating this these ruins, this attack aftermath, that without PO it really wouldn't have been possible, or at least not without, again, custom assets. So what I'm doing here is I'm using these burned pier props. I think they are from New York. They are just wooden piles that used to be the supports for some ferry piers, but I think it just burned down and now they're just sticking out of the water in New York. But here on this build, I can use them perfectly for the support pillars of these longhouses. And you'll see that in just a few seconds. Yeah. That they have the perfect sort of dimensions and everything, that, yeah, I really was lucky to be able to use them. In a second step now, I'm just placing these lock props, made them darker using PO again, And yeah, just to have some more beams and wooden pillars and supporting thingies that survived the fire, because yeah, all of these buildings are made out of three major materials. You have the main supports that are just trees, basically just logs rammed into the ground. These are the main supports. Then you have the roof that is made out of thatch or hay, and then you have the walls that are made out of loam. So everything burns on these buildings. So I had really the possibility to completely eradicate the village, and so that nothing is left next to a few wooden beams that survived. And since when such a huge wooden construction burns completely to the ground, you of course also have a bit of scorched earth or scorched ground around it, and that is what I used some of Ronix's pile or dirt ground decals for. Turned them black using PO, and et voila, you have a burnt ground which fits really well. And just to have some again burnt and fallen down woods and wood beams, I'm using these wooden debris props. I think they are from the Natural Disaster DLC. Don't quote me on that, but I'm somewhat sure they're from that DLC. Sadly, I wasn't able to turn them into POs and also make them black. But yeah, they're gray now, and seriously, they also work really well in this gray color. And imagine if the whole village burns down. Of course, also all the trees standing right next to the buildings burned down. And so what I did to achieve that look is just using some of the fall trees that Mr. Mason made and plopped them where the trees used to be. Because when a tree burns, usually it's just the leaves that burn, and at least in many cases the trunk survives, because trees are actually surprisingly well in terms of defending themselves from fire, at least if it's a sort of normal fire and not these huge fires that are in some places of the world right now, where there's I think nothing to be done for these trees there. But on a smaller scale, or on a more natural scale, like here, trees are very much able to defend themselves and able to survive fires. In fact, it's even a small fire is even really good for dense forests, and so usually trees survive that, and that is why I used these trees here. Of course, all these fences are also made out of wood, so just as the houses, they go. They are completely gone. I had a bit of a difficult time to figure out what I'm doing with these earth fast houses in terms of displaying them as ruins. What I did is just turning all of them into POs, darkening them, and just displaying a collapsed roof, which I don't think it's a perfect solution for this, but it definitely worked enough for the short sequence in this video and in the last video. So yeah, I'm also satisfied with that. And the last step will then be adding some fire and smoke everywhere, just to display that indeed some of the wood parts are still burning and everything is smoking, just to get that really apocalyptic aftermath feeling. But again, We're coming closer to the end of the video. In fact, this is the last part of the video now, where I'm putting all these effects. So I'd like to thank you for watching this video again, and I really hope you like the second episode as well as the whole project of mine. If you liked it, definitely, you know, like the video, comment on the video, and of course subscribe to my channel, hit the tiny bell icon to get notified when the story continues. As usual, a huge thanks to my patrons that helped me so massively into making this whole project possible. And if you want to get in touch with me or others, feel free to hop on my Discord server where we can have a nice discussion. That's it from my side. Have fun with the cinematics now. I'll see you in the next video. Until then, stay healthy, stay tuned. Bye.